Hello and welcome back. This is the third lesson on animating Genesis figures from Dash to J in Blender using Rig-GNS. In this video, we're going to look at the functions of some of the buttons within the Animix setup. In our scene, I have gone ahead and assigned additional animations to the female character. And I've also added animations to the male character as well. Now let's play the animation to see them in action. You can see both characters gracefully walk into view. The male character stands in observation, folding his hands, now mocking his opponent. The female responds with a dismissive wrist gesture, ready to fight, and the male responds with a laugh as he then goes into a combat pose. The female initiates the first attack as the male evades, and in retaliation, he launches a counter attack, delivering a powerful kick on her face. Alright, that's the animation. Let me pause it right there. Now, I want to share some of the techniques I use while making this animation. One thing I found myself doing often is splitting the animation to trim away excess parts. To do this, position the playhead to the point you want to split the strip and then press Y to split it. So I just split the strip. There are instances where I remove part of the animations that I don't need, so let me press Ctrl Z to undo that. Another function I frequently use is found right here in the properties of the NLA editor in the Action Clip tab called the Playback Speed. I often use this playback speed option to adjust the animation's tempo. Let me use this on this last animation strip here. I will position the playhead to the moment of impact where he kicks her on the face. Now, by adjusting the playback speed here, you can slow down the animation significantly. Let me match the frame rate to the animation. Now, when I hit play, you'll notice how the animation unfolds at a much slower pace. This allowed me to achieve the desired timing for the different parts of the animation. Now let's move on to refining the animation with some of the buttons in the Animix setup. I will go to the first frame, press 1 on the numpad to switch to front view, and then zoom out. I'll begin with the female character by collapsing these tracks and expanding that for the female. The animation starts with the walking strip. From the beginning of the animation, you will notice that the character's foot sinks below this red line, which represents the floor level. I want to have this foot up on the floor, and to do that, I'll use the position button here in the panel. If you use the position button, you need to select the animation strip and press tab to enter tweak mode, which is like the edit mode for the keyframes. So now by holding shift and clicking the position button, you can adjust the animation vertically by dragging the mouse up. With that adjusted, I'll press tab to exit tweak mode. Now when I play the animation, you can see the foot is now on the floor. However, once the playhead crosses to the next strip, the character sinks back below the floor level. So instead of adjusting each strip individually, I'll decide a reasonable length of strip that I would like to make the adjustment on. I will fix the foot sinking issue from the beginning of the animation to the point where she transitioned from walking to a fight pose, which is around frame 133. Now with the character selected, ensure that there is no animation assigned here in the big action panel. Then go ahead and click the big button. Set the end frame to 133 and click OK. Now we have the animation in the big actions. I can rename this to combined walking. Now it means I no longer need these strips, so I'll go ahead and delete their tracks, delete this as well. I'm also going to delete these empty tracks because I don't need them. I will go to the first frame. Now I'm playing the combined animation, which you see that the feet is on the floor but then suddenly sank back below the floor level. Using the position button to adjust the floor level for this action wouldn't be the ideal solution since the foot level varies. For instance, if I choose to adjust the foot to the floor level with the position button, now when I go back a few frames in the animation, you'll see that the part we adjusted earlier has the character positioned too high, even though the feet is back on the floor in subsequent frames. Now a better approach to fix the floor issue is by using this button here in the panel that says to floor, but first, make sure you're on a frame where the character is positioned on the floor. In this frame, you can see the character is on the floor, so I can go ahead and click the to floor button. But again, if you don't have any of the character's foot on the floor level throughout the animation, you can either use the position button here to place the character's foot on the floor, or you can go to pose mode, select the torso bone, and then move it on the z-axis to position the character's foot on the floor like this. Now after that, you can go ahead and select the to floor button, but again, it is essential to determine the range of frames you want the character to be on the floor. And in this case, we want the entire animation up to this point, frame 134. So let me go back to the beginning of the animation. Move the torso bone again to ensure the foot's on the floor level. Now I will click to floor, and in the pop-up option, we'll apply it to frame 133 and I'll click OK. Now when I go back to the beginning and play the animation, you can see the character is on the floor throughout the animation, which is precisely what this to floor button does. Now I'm going to repeat this process for the male character. First, I will collapse these tracks, switch to object mode, and select the male character. After expanding these tracks, I will determine the range of animation I would like to apply the to floor function. For this animation, it will be up to the end of this angry strip, which is around frame 258. Before clicking the break animation button, make sure you have a strip selected, then click the break animation button. And in the pop-up option, I will change the end frame to 248 and click OK. Now I have the animation in the baked action. I'll rename it to walking into scene. Alright, so it means I no longer need these strips. I'll go ahead and delete their tracks and remove some of the empty tracks as well. Let me drag this to bring the picked animation into view in the NLA. Now when I zoom in on the male character, you can see that the character's foot isn't touching the floor but is instead hovering above it. To fix this, on any frame, you can use the position button or go to pose mode and use the torso bone to move the character to the floor. Then click to floor, set it for the entire 248 frames and click OK. Now when we play the animation, you can see the character walking on the floor. Alright, let's watch the animation again from a different angle. If you closely observe the feet of this character, you'll notice a subtle sideways movement of the character. Around this point, you can see the character sliding to the right side as he then slides back to the left. Now, I will mark the point on the timeline when the sliding occurs. The sliding started around this frame, that's frame 98. I'll press M on the timeline to mark that frame. Playing the animation again, I will check to see when the character slides back, which is around the end frame, frame 246. I'll press M on the timeline to mark that as well. Now I'm going to fix this sliding issue by using IK bones to anchor the feet. I'm going to start with the left foot, focusing on frame 100 to frame 244. Now within the panel, we have the switch all IK FK button, which toggles between IK and FK bones for the entire limbs of the character. And below it is another IK FK button, which lets you toggle between IK and FK for a specific limb that can be enabled here. This corresponds to the right hand. This is for the left hand, right leg, and left leg. So with the left leg enabled, clicking the switch IK FK button switches the left leg to IK, and clicking again returns to FK. Now I want to ensure that the IK bones on the left leg copies the FK bone. So with the left leg enabled here, I'll use the snap button labeled IK to FK to do that. When I switch to IK, you can see the IK bones are currently not copying the FK bones. Now by clicking the snap IK to FK button, I get a dialog box that allows me to specify the range of frames for this action. Remember, our frame range is 100 to 244. So I will set the start frame to 100. The end frame to 244, leave the frame step as 1 and click OK. This process can be really time consuming, so I strongly recommend specifying only a reasonable number of frames for the snapping action. The more frames, the longer it takes to execute. Okay, it just finished snapping IK bones to FK for the left leg and it took approximately 1.5 minutes to snap across the total of 144 frames. I will probably need to revisit the code to improve the execution time. Now let me switch to IK for the left leg and zoom in to clearly see the IK bones. I will switch back to FK and then back to IK When I move the playhead between frame 100 and 244, you will see that the IK animation perfectly mirrors the FK. However, if I go back to frames before 100, you will see that the IK bones are no longer copying the FK bones. But as soon as I reach frame 100, the IK bone copies the FK bones. Keyframe animation with IK bone is generally easier than with FK. The FK bones only serve to animate the figures with the imported animation. So now, to eliminate the sideways sliding of the feet using keyframe animation, I will split this window and change the one below to dope sheet. Here, I already have the dope sheet in action editor mode, which can be accessed here. I will now select the left foot IK bone and then check for keyframes on the dope sheet. So I will maximize the dope sheet and zoom out to ensure frames 100 to 244 are in view. Now I'll go back to the previous window. Since we only snapped for 100 to 244, make sure you have those frames visible in the dope sheet to see the keyframes. You want to begin by analyzing the animation to understand how to address the sliding issue. The goal is to ensure the character's feet remain in their position. Let me expand the keyframes to reveal the location keyframes as they control the movement of the foot IK bone. Now I'm going to zoom in on the keyframes and press B to box select, then drag to highlight only the X, Y, and Z location keyframes. I will delete the selected keyframes, zoom out to reveal the rest of the frames, highlight the remaining keyframes, and I will delete them except for this very last frame. Alright, now let's play the animation to see what we did. You can see the foot still slides, although it's different from before. To improve the results, I will highlight the X, Y, and Z location keyframes on this frame. Then using Shift D, I will copy these keyframes all the way to the endpoint. Let me reveal the last frames. Now I'll move the copied keyframes to replace the last keyframe. Now let's preview the animation. I will hide the overlays and play it once more. Alright, for now, I am satisfied with the adjustment on the left leg. I will proceed to do the same for the right leg. I will turn the overlays back on and enable the right leg button in the panel. Then I will click the Snap IK to FK button, set the frame rate from 100 to 244, and then click OK. This might take another 1.5 minutes to finish. Okay, the process of snapping the IK bones to FK was just completed. Now with the right leg enabled, I will toggle between IK and FK, but of course I will be using the IK bones. Next, I will select the foot IK here, then expand the keyframes, and proceed to analyze the sliding. So here, I'm going to delete the location keyframes for this animation, just like we did for the left leg. So now I will set the playhead to a frame before the sliding. Box select and highlight the three location keyframes on all frames except the first, and then delete them. I'll proceed to select the remaining keyframes and delete them as well. Now I will select X, Y, and Z keyframes on this frame, press Shift D to duplicate, and then move them to the end of our keyframes. Now when I play the animation, you can see that both feet are now fixed in place, staying where they should be. Well, I think the rotation keyframes here are redundant, so I will just delete them. Now play the animation again. You can see how the leg is now stable and doesn't slide away. Now that I'm satisfied with the fit, I will proceed to copy the keyframes of the IK bones to the FK bones by going to the panel. With the right bone enabled, I will click the FK to IK button. Set the frame range from 100 to 244 and then click OK. Fortunately, FK to IK doesn't take as much time as IK to FK. Once it is executed for the right leg, I'll repeat the process for the left leg by enabling it in the panel and clicking the FK to IK button. I will set the frame range to 100 to 244 and then click OK. Now I'll switch the left leg back to FK and do the same for the right leg. And now when I play the animation from the beginning, you can see that the foot is more firmly fixed on the ground. Okay, so that concludes this lesson. The next lesson we'll look at how we can export this animation to DAZ Studio. If you found this video helpful, please consider liking the video and subscribing to the channel. Thank you for your time. Till next time.